Hi, what's up guys? Today I would like to create a new tutorial using C4D. I think before 1 year ago I uploaded the product pack shot using C4D. Now I am revealing my rendering and lighting techniques. So I think it's very simple. I used some grayscale gorilla product. So let's go jump to C4D. So this is our scene before the previous part we created. So to add lighting, I use HDRI lighting from Grayscale Gorilla product. So this is HDR studio rig. It's an easy method to add some add lighting. So before we start, we add some global illumination. You can add by right button on here and click on the global illumination. Then change the preset to object visualization preview. It's the best method for best preset for preview of your product. There is no extra time, there is no extra rendering time, so best it. So I just rendering with the basic lighting. So you can see the basic lighting is okay. So if you want to change the HDRI image, so if you want to change the lighting of this HDRI, so you can choose open browser and use your own HDRI images. Then change it and you can render it again. So see the difference. So you can check every HDR images and find a suitable HDRI. Then also you can change the background color of the seamless floor by using seamless floor control. Okay, I think I used the dark orange and light orange in previous tutorial in my work. So you can set it to your own style, your own colors. Okay, and now I am explaining how I create this camera animation. So this is a basic scene and create one camera and set it, the angle of ending angle, and copy that camera, and this is our first angle. So set the first angle of view. And this is our first angle and name it to camera 1, and this is our second angle. Okay, create like this two angled cameras. Now we want to morph between these two cameras, so you can create any new camera. I think it's okay. Yeah, so create a new camera and you can name it to main or anything. It's not important. So add a camera morph tag to the main camera. Then change the view to the main camera, and in morph tag you can change the multi morph and add the camera 1 and 2. Okay. Then when you change the value of blend, you can see the animation between camera 1 to 2. I just turn off the camera. Okay, you can blend between camera 1 to next. Okay, so you can animate between, you can animate in blend. I add a keyframe on the 0 frame and 100 frame. Okay, add another key. Okay, if you, and also you can soft, you can interpolation is smooth movement, and also you can stabilize the object. I set the can for the stabilization. So if you play, you can see the camera animation perfectly. If you add lighting, and here I add some global illumination and make it preset the object visualization preview, and also add some material to our object. Making a reflection material, I add and also add some glass material. So next we want to add, I think, the reflection. Add some another material for. Okay, this is our basic rendering. Okay. So we need to add some depth of field to the glass. Say everything is infinity focusing. So we want to add some depth of field. I changed the material. It's not okay. So before you, if you want to add depth of field, change the render to physical and turn on the depth of field. Then go to the camera. Okay, with the second camera. And this is our camera focal length. You can see our Canon orange is now focusing. Okay, you can add another method to add focusing by using focus object. Just drag your object to the focus object. Now perfectly focusing. Or if you add the glass, you can see now glass is focusing. Okay, you can check, set your own product for focusing. Okay, now our can is focusing, and another method focusing, I just clear the focus object, and focus distance, just click on any focus is the best way to focus. So I use focus object. Then if you want to add, okay, if you render it, now there is no focusing is okay, but there is no depth of field. I increase the floor size for a little bit. Okay, now we want more background blurry. So go to physical and f-stop aperture, set it to 1 and render it again and test your file. It's not okay, so I change it to 0.1. Now render it again. Yeah, it's okay. So find your perfect value for your scene. Now go to the main scene, and you can see the morph camera and multi camera and here, and also the f-stop value. Now I just change, and also you can use the exterior HDR images. For the high quality images, I think it's more render time. I think it's take more render time. Or you can HDR images more more quality, but it's more time. So I just use object visualization and save it to and find the choose the folder where you want to save. So I just choose the desktop. Or you can set the, you can create a new folder name it any, just like frames for product tag short frames out anything. Okay, and I just save it to desktop. And also here is the method, the format JPEG, and you can choose any format, but you, if you have to color correct it more detailing, so just use the EXR file. Open EXR file. I think it's not here. Yeah, it's here. Yes, open EXR is the more bit, more depth in colors. Okay, you can deeply color correct it when you post color grading process. Okay, I think it's the best format for color grading. And if you want to, and also you can set the frame range. Okay, if you want to old frame rendering, set the old frame. Or adjust current, use for testing current frame and render it. So our final image is okay. Next part is how to color grading. So hope you enjoy. If you like it, please subscribe.